What's up, travelers? It's Eliz from Means to Travel coming to you today from beautiful St. George, Utah. And today we are going to go over the top things to do when you come and visit Southern Utah. So let's get into it. And the first thing we're going to talk to you all about is that we are staying in St. George, Utah pretty much on purpose. So St. George is really easy to get to from Las Vegas, and it's one of the larger cities in Southern Utah. So it's an excellent option for a home base when you're here. It's really close to a lot of the local attractions, and I'll get into that in 1 second. But it also is just large enough that it has the amenities that you associate with a larger town or smaller city. For example, you're going to find a lot of really great restaurant options. There's Mexican food, there's Asian food. We really like Benja Thai and sushi here. And there's just a lot of different things that you can try when you're here and not get sick of same old food all the time. Then there's also a lot of hotel accommodations, a lot of chain hotels in this area that you are able to access, as well as a pretty thriving VRBO market. We've opted to stay for a month here right now, so we're staying in a VRBO that we're very pleased with. The last thing I want to say has to do with all of the attractions that I was mentioning before. There are so many things within driving distance around here. There's state parks, there's Zion National Park within an hour away, and a lot of really cool outdoor things to do beyond that even. So definitely consider staying in St. George as your accommodation location when you're here. And now we're gonna drill down to some of the actual things to do while you're here in Southern Utah. And the top thing, the thing that most people think about, are the beautiful national parks in this state. There are 5 national parks in Utah, and there's 3 within driving distance from St. George that are located in what we consider to be Southern Utah. There's Capitol Reef National Park, that's 3.5 hours away, and Bryce Canyon National Park is about 2 hour driving distance, and then Zion National Park is an hour or less, depending on where you're at in this area. So those are within great range for being able to explore every single day one of the national parks. And speaking about Zion, which I mentioned is the closest to where we're at right now, it's also the most visited park. There's over 4 million people that visit Zion National Park each year, and that makes it pretty busy. So starting March 13th of at least this year, which is 2021, the shuttle service runs instead of being able to drive into the park, and you have to get your shuttle pass in advance. So it's important that you do your research when you're visiting, especially this park, but all the national parks. Doing your research kind of means making sure that you maybe need a ticket to get in, or maybe need to book your shuttle passes in advance, which there's shuttles at, say, Bryce Canyon a lot of times too in the busier seasons, and just making sure that you have everything kind of checked off the list that you need to think about before going. We were able to buy our national parks pass once we got to the national park, and it's about $80 to do an annual pass, or it's about $35 a day. So if you're visiting all 3 parks, the annual pass makes total sense. But that's something that you can do as soon as you arrive and are about to enter through the gate. That's the same case within Bryce Canyon National Park, for example, too, which, as I mentioned, is about 2 hours away. It's a completely different landscape from Zion. Definitely plan your day in order to explore Bryce and go into the amphitheater when you're there. The final park that I want to mention is much less visited than the other two that I just said, and that one's Capitol Reef National Park. Capitol Reef National Park, though, even though it's only about like 1 million, a little bit more visitors per year, it's just as beautiful. It's just a little bit harder to get to from some of those home bases, so you're going to have potentially a little bit more space. But make sure you do your research as well, figure out what you want to do once you're there and when things are open, so that way you optimize your time within the national parks that are so great to do when you're here in Southern Utah. We were actually able to do all 3 of the national parks, Zion, Bryce, and Capitol Reef, within a 2-day drive, just one overnight at Bryce Canyon. We didn't get to do a lot of hiking because it was just a lot of driving. And I think because we were there in early March, before there was any sort of coordination needed with shuttle passes and stuff like that, we were able to make it work. Definitely research, though, because we made it work during off season. And if that's something that maybe you have a little bit more time constraint, you might still be able to go to 2 or 3 parks when you're here, even if you're not here for a full week. In addition to the national parks, you should also absolutely check out some of the state parks here in southern Utah, which can be just as beautiful. Some of the popular ones here are Sand Hollow, Gunlock, and also Snow Canyon State Park. You will, if you're especially an out-of-stater, we have an out-of-state license plate even, you will have to pay an even higher fee than even if you live in the state of Utah in order to get into the state parks, but they're absolutely still worth visiting, especially if you have the time. We've really liked entering into Snow Canyon State Park via Padre Canyon, which you're able to hike kind of into the mountain and then into the state park itself. That one was an awesome hike. Absolutely recommend you guys checking that out. It is pretty challenging for people who aren't kind of active hikers, so just giving you a heads up there. Padre Canyon is also part of a protected area called Red Cliffs Desert Natural Reserve, and in like kind of this time of year, which is early March, late February time every year, there's desert tortoises that you might even get to see. We unfortunately didn't get to see any and I was pretty bummed about it, but you have to be on the lookout. And I love that there's so much conservation efforts around making sure that those tortoises have excellent migration patterns. And the next thing to consider when you're coming to southern Utah is that there's also a ton of more local hikes. You don't have to go to state parks and national parks just to be able to enjoy nature. One of our favorite local hikes was on the Anasazi Trail right outside of St. George, kind of towards Santa Clara. And that one was super cool because there's a lot of Native American history around here, and there's actually a lot of petroglyphs that you can see in the southern Utah area. And that trail, I mean, you can absolutely see a ton of them. And that's just really cool and neat, and you can bring kids because it's a pretty easy approachable trail. We recommend, if you're interested in trying to figure out different trails to do, definitely look into downloading the All Trails app. And that's gonna give you a lot of the different trail options and list how easy, medium, or difficult they are based on your skill level. You might be able to use that information to make decisions about which ones to do. And it's not just hiking you can do in this area. There's also water activities to do as well. Just within the St. George area, there's Sand Hollow Reservoir that a lot of locals might go to swim or boat or anything like that. If you want to drive a little bit further, there's of course the famous Lake Powell, which is on the border between Utah and Arizona. And if you wanted to drive all the way into Nevada from here, you could also try to go to Lake Mead. And speaking of Lake Mead and Nevada, that brings us to the final thing that I'm going to share with you when you're visiting southern Utah, and that is to leave Utah. Go explore some of the neighboring states. So a couple of the most popular things to do, the first one that I'm going to talk about is driving down to the Grand Canyon, which is extremely easy to do if you are here in St. George. The most popular thing from here is to go to the north rim of the Grand Canyon, which is a lot less visited than the south rim, but it's actually not open year-round. So this year in 2021, it is going to be open from May 15th to October 15th, so definitely make sure that you are going to be able to access it when you're considering that drive. It is only a 2.5 hour drive from St. George, so you could probably do it as a day trip, but definitely look into that and make sure that that amount of driving and the north rim would be open if you are considering that as an option. Another option is to go visit Las Vegas. So Las Vegas is about a 2 hour drive from St. George. A lot of people actually come here by landing in Las Vegas and renting a car and coming out here. And it's certainly a wonderful place to visit. I'm sure a lot of you guys have already heard of it, but it gives you a little bit of a different flair than maybe the southern Utah feel. You're gonna see a lot of shows, a lot of huge hotels. Maybe you like to gamble, I don't know. But definitely something to look into if you're gonna be in this area and want a little bit more of a party moment in your trip. So I hope you guys liked this list of the top things to do when you visit southern Utah. If you did, give this video a thumbs up down below, and definitely press that red subscribe button down below too if you want to see more of the travel videos on this channel and more of our videos to come. Thanks everybody for watching. Cheers. Enjoy Utah. Happy travels. Bye. Hey travelers, don't forget to subscribe and let's hang out more. Here are some links to other helpful travel videos on my channel, and press that notification bell so you don't miss any new and awesome travel videos to come.